the one moment that I really remember is not because it was great, was because it was terrible. We were brought out to Minneapolis, Minnesota to do a show at the Mall of America, and we were doing this show called The Real Real World, which is an improvised version of The Real World. And we got up on stage at this place called Knuckleheads, and no one, I think, told anyone at Knuckleheads that the Friday 8 o'clock show was going to be improv. They were expecting stand-up. And when I say we bombed, it's an understatement. Like, we collapsed in such a way, not even because of us, the audience just turned on us. Within the first 2 minutes of the show, literally the first 2 minutes, the audience was yelling, "Kill yourself! Kill yourself!" And we all looked at each other and we knew we had to finish the show. And we finished the show with the most aggressive energy coming at us from an audience. But it's the benefit of improv over stand-up, because at the end of the day, we had each other on stage and we flopped and we bombed and we sucked together.
I had this idea to do, we called it Dirty Baghdad, and I was like in a burqa, and it was this idea that I'd like fallen in love with this American soldier played by Sudeikis, and that he was leaving, and it was a play on Dirty Dancing. The guys in the cast were like, "I don't think that's gonna be super funny, right?" Because we would, in rehearsal, I brought it to rehearsal, and they're like, "We don't think that's gonna be great." And I was like, "Trust me, women of my generation are gonna go apeshit over this. They're gonna love it." And then our director was like, "Well, let's try it out. We'll just see. We won't choreograph everything, but we'll just see how the audience responds to this idea. And if they like it, then we'll be serious about it, and you can rewrite it, and we can figure out the out to the scene and whatever." Okay, so it's the night of the first time showing this. It's going really well. It's fine. Like, we're getting little laughs here and there. It's a little clunky, but it's going okay. And now I'm wearing, this is so offensive, but I'm wearing a black t-shirt that's, like, not, all you can see is my eyes, as my burqa. And then the song, you know, "I Had the Time of My Life" comes on, just that needle drop of that, and the audience went banana cakes. And I'm behind a t-shirt, so you can't see my mouth, but I'm like, I have sizable teeth. I have like a pretty big mouth. And I was just smiling, like you could probably just see my eyes were watering up, because I was like smiling from here to here. And then like, Sudeikis did a whole like Patrick Swayze type of thing, and then we did there was a couple of dance moves that we had ready for the audience, and I felt like I was Jennifer Grey. Like, I felt like this is, I felt like I was in that movie, and it was amazing, and I'll never forget that moment because it was just so special.
Probably the craziest thing that happened to me in a show was, we were doing a Herald, my team, last day of school. We used to be a Herald team. And I was walking toward Paul Rust, and I said the last line of the show. It turned out to be the last line. So that got a blackout, which, you know, we don't know when it's going to happen, but it did. And I just kept walking, and I walked straight into Paul, and the lights came up. I was like, "Whoa." And walked backstage, and immediately someone coming on for the next show was like, "Hey, whoa, a man." And I was like, And I came back here, right here, to this dressing room, and I looked in the mirror, and I just had blood pouring out of my nose, and my nose was like a little crick, and I literally went like right here into this mirror, and then I had to go to the hospital and stuff, and my nose still has a dent right on the bridge up here because slamming into Paul.
Here's the thing. I don't remember the specific situation, but Shannon O'Neill, who was on my team in New York and is a great friend, had done something so funny, she'd like killed all of us or something in the scene. So we were all on the floor, and it was so funny that I wet my pants from laughing. So I do actually wet my pants, not infrequently, but never on stage, like from laughing. It's just something. So, but on stage, I don't make a like regular habit of it. But so I did this time, and I was like on the ground, and I think I felt so at ease. I don't know what, but I let my guard down and like my pee blocker. And so anyway, so I wet my pants. And then Shannon started dragging us. Like, she was, after she had killed us, she was like dragging us to the, I don't know, other place. And so you could see, so Shannon saw it. She was like, "What?" There was this long streak of pee along the floor. And I don't know how it ended. I don't know if the audience noticed or not. I got up and I said, like, "Shannon, I wet my pants." So she looked at the back. She could see that the pants were wet. It is something, if you're not looking for it, people aren't generally like looking at the bottom of your pants, or at your bottom, I guess. But So I don't know if people noticed or not, but it was one of those things where I was like, this is so joyful. I know that sounds weird, but I was like, this is what it's about. Because it was, at the end of the day, it felt like up there with your good friends. Luckily, I loved my team, so it was up there with your good friends sharing this humiliating, horrible moment that was actually lovely because it was like tragedy, and that makes you stronger. So that was my favorite show that I was in.